We are beginning tonight with a controversial new program in Santa Cruz County. It's a needle exchange program.
And the programs up to now have brought a lot of controversy. The program is being modified after many in the community voiced concerns about finding needles in their neighborhoods, and they've been washing up on nearby beaches. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live tonight in our Salinas newsroom with details of the new approach.
Well, Dan, there is debate over whether the one-for-one needle exchange program enhances safety or perhaps something it might put it at risk. Neighbors say there are enough drug and needle problems in their area, and they worry that this program could, on some levels, advocate drug use.
There's a problem when you can walk on the sidewalk and step on a needle.
Wham! Ow, what the hell?
I looked down and sure enough, there's a needle sticking out of my foot. And it's like I tugged on it, couldn't get it out. Ellie had to, I had to hold my foot and have her yank it out.
The moment Chris Chapman stepped on a needle on a Santa Cruz sidewalk turned into a grassroots campaign to clean up and bring attention to an area they say is littered with sharp, tiny landmines. A search Friday near the Chapman's home turned up these.
We found 30 needles. Within 10 minutes, the police were there to clean it up.
Santa Cruz County Health Services hopes launching a newly formatted needle exchange program can help.
I'm not happy about it. That just means more people all hours.
We know it doesn't increase crime. It doesn't encourage drug use either.
The new program focuses on keeping dirty needles out of the community by reducing improper disposure of those needles. Santa Cruz County health workers will offer a one-to-one needle exchange program Monday to Friday from 8 to 5, Thursday until 6, and a second location at the Watsonville Health Center from 8 to 7, Monday through Friday.
It is a proven way to decrease communicable disease, especially HIV and hepatitis C.
Neighbors hope the extended hours and days won't create more problems or encourage illegal drug use.
I gotta live my life as if I'm infected.
On a daily basis, when I take my daughter for a walk, I am in front of her looking for loose needles. I'm making sure she's wearing the toughest tennis shoes she can.
They come in, get their supplies, and they leave. They're not staying around. They're getting the services and leaving.
Now, one of the concerns that community members are expressing are about the actual one-to-one exchange. There is an exception for certain medical conditions, and the question is what those medical conditions are. Now, there are 36 other programs like this, at least in the state of California, that have set somewhat of a precedent. So there are referrals to that and to see where this goes in the future, Dan.
All right. Thank you very much, Brittany. Now, this one-for-one program wouldn't go into effect for another month. It would start April 30th.